Taking the information from all the previous lectures regarding the structure of the atom, we'll now place what we know in a table. Number one, there are three particles that make up the atom. There's the electron, the proton, and the neutron. These have symbols, E negative, P plus, N zero. They have charges. The electron has a relative charge of minus one, where the proton has an equal but opposite charge of plus one, and the neutron has no charge. They have masses. The proton has a mass of one atomic mass unit. The neutron has a mass of one atomic mass unit. Most of the mass of an atom is concentrated in these two particles. An electron, however, has a mass of about 1/2000th of an atomic mass unit. Where are these located? Well, the proton and the neutron make up the nucleus. Whereas the electron is found outside the nucleus. Now, let's look a little closer at what happens when you vary the number of neutrons in a nucleus. As we've seen, when you change the number of neutrons in a nucleus, you don't change its positive charge, and therefore you don't change the type of element it represents. Atoms of the same element that differ in the number of neutrons are called isotopes. They have the same atomic number, that's number of protons, but they have different mass numbers, the sum of protons and neutrons. In order to represent isotopes, we use isotope notation. Our isotope notation works like this. The symbol X represents the element. The atomic number is shown below, represented as Z. And the mass number is above, represented by A. Isotope notation works like this. If we look at this sample nucleus, we have 1, 2 protons. That means that the atomic number is 2. If we go to the periodic table, the element with an atomic number of 2, or in other words, the one that has 2 protons in its nucleus, is helium. And therefore, that determines the atomic symbol we write down. In this particular example, this nucleus also has a total of 1, 2 neutrons, which means that the sum of the protons and neutrons in this nucleus give it a mass number of 4. We call this helium-4. The other example, we have 2 protons. Again, making this a helium atom. However, it's not the same as the previous helium atom because its nucleus contains 3 neutrons. Having extra neutrons doesn't change how many electrons you can hold, but it does change the mass of the nucleus. It is now 1 atomic mass unit heavier We call this isotope helium-5.